From the Philippines, the Wing Chun actually that I teach has been modified. My instructor, Danny Inosanto, was Bruce Lee's disciple and training partner for over 10 years. So as a result of that, we have a combination of Bruce Lee's system and the Kali, which is a Filipino art.
You know, we've been talking about your the professions of boxing and karate, but just before you became a boxer and karate, you were involved as president of a school.
The college I attended, Ventura, I was student body president.
Homecoming queen?
Well, I've won 3 different beauty pageants at different times of my life.
And what are these, the women that you were involved with, or the people that you were involved with these different activities, what do they say about Grace Casillas, who is now involved in kicking people and hitting people in the face and trying to knock them out? And let me tell you why I say that, because you're quoted as saying, but at the moment a knockout happens, it's very exciting. There is a rush when you hit somebody with a clean, solid punch. You know your whole body clicked. I mean, that's a warrior talking.
But that's also, it just happens that this is a particular sport that I've selected. How does it feel when you hit that ball and you're playing baseball and you hit a clean home run? It's exciting, isn't it? It just happens that this is exciting to me. As far as beating people up, I don't think about it that way. I mean, that click, that feeling of knocking someone out is sort of just showing that all your homework, everything you've done, that you've proven that it all works, whether it's hitting a baseball bat, whether it's playing tennis, and having a clean, you know, sweeping movement. So as far as what women think about me, I think most women are real happy. In other words, they're excited and they see me as a role model, and it encourages them, not maybe to be fighters, but to do something else that they want to do.
I want to talk about what you're going to be doing in a couple of years, possibly after boxing and karate. So don't run away, okay?
Okay.
And we'll be back with Grace right after this message. Don't run away. And in this corner, we have Grace Casillas. Welcome to the show again.
I don't know if Casillas would like that invitation.
By the way, I understand you wear a skirt.
Sometimes
well, I mean
I
boxing.
Do.
I mean boxing.
It's sort of my trademark. When I first started fighting, they'd make us wear these big baggy trunks, and they didn't look too attractive, especially because they were made for men. So I decided, well, I want to make sure people know that I'm a woman, so I designed a little skirt to wear.
Are you... You just said, I want to make people aware that I'm a woman.
Yes.
Does that bother you? When you're in a profession that generally has been known that only... Yeah, dominated by men?
No, it doesn't really bother me, but I'm aware that people are still sort of, you know, the women, right? And mm-hmm. As far as being a professional boxer, they stereotype you thinking that you can't possibly be feminine. So just for those people that might have doubts, I just want to make sure.
Well, hey, I'll tell you something. I don't have doubts. I mean, I'm looking at you, and they're all looking at
Neither
you.
Neither do I.
I don't think anybody out there has. I don't think doubts exist at this point. But the mere fact that you're involved in a male-dominated sport at the present time, does this have something to do with your ego, self-satisfaction? Is it a visible kind of career that you want to do something else, and this is the only way you can get that big long step, the first step to get into acting or something like that?
I think there's a lot easier ways to become an actress than fighting your way to the top, but when I first got involved in the sport, I don't think I really focused on that it was a male-dominated sport. It was just sort of a natural thing that happened, you know, from training to fighting. Now, after being involved in it for years, I definitely am aware of that. And that's why at this point, after fighting for so many years, being undefeated, having 30 fights, I've really stopped to think about that. And you know, I'm sort of coming to the conclusion that I've done as much as I can here, and I can't go any higher with it. I don't have, you know, at this point, the visible career that I thought I would have if I were a man and had a world title. Because there aren't that many women in the sport. And it's sort of a struggle, even before you get in the fight, convincing the world or convincing promoters that you're serious, that you're legitimate, that you really want, you know, equal rights as the men do.
But do they use you as I'm just going to use this for lack of a better word, a freak.
Don't pull any punches, okay?
As a freak show between men, between men boxing, different rounds, and they put you in the middle?
I won't use the word freak show. I'll use entertainment for the men. I'm aware that...
Does that bother you?
It doesn't bother me.
Whistling the whole thing?
Remember, I have the master's in psychology. Okay. No, every time I fight, I'm aware that that is sort of the promoter's idea. And it's okay because I'm very confident that even though they're using me to promote the fight, there's two pretty ladies that are going to punch each other out. I know that the minute that bell rings, that everybody's going to stop and look. And that's the way it's been every time I fought. So that's sort of been the price I've had to pay to earn the respect of the audience.
So that carnival atmosphere that takes place within the audience automatically becomes a very,
very
serious
it's
audience.
It's very short. It's very short. And you know, so I love entertaining the people. And every time I fought, the people respond very positively. And so I'm aware of that, and it doesn't bother me anymore because I know that I'm going to change their attitude.
What about your parents? You're one of one child, 11 children in the family.
Right.
What about your parents? I understand your father's behind you, but what about your mother?
Well, I think my family overall, they love me very much, so they're supportive of everything I do. And even though they might not agree totally with what I'm doing or don't think that it's not the way they would do it, I think they're behind me 100%.
Were they behind you when you did that Playboy piece?
That's a good point. They were hurt that I would do something and that I wouldn't collaborate with them. Mm-hmm. Why didn't you ask us our opinion? But in a very short... Why did I do Playboy? Let me finish this point first.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay. Then I'll tell you why I did Playboy. After, you know, a month or so, they just sort of realized that I want a visible career. I want to be I am an actress, but I want to make films, and that was a decision that I made, so they were going to be behind me. That's the way my family reacted. Now, why did I do?
I'm not going to get you to the Playboy. I'm asking you the same question your parents probably asked you. Why Playboy?
Do you want me to give you the answer again?
Gracia, my mom? Why Playboy, Gracia? I just can see your parents saying that to you right now.
Why Playboy? For a couple of reasons. One real obvious reason is that I'm getting ready to step out of one ring and into another ring. I'm getting ready to step out of the fight world into the acting world. I've been preparing myself for it for almost 2 years now. And Playboy is an obvious vehicle for me. It's given me a lot of publicity, and I want a visible career. Number two, I love teaching. I am teaching. I teach in various areas in Los Angeles. But one facet of that is that I realize that a lot of women are afraid to enter contact sports or even something physical, like taking a self-defense class. So that, you know, I realize with being in Playboy, a lot of women saw Playboy. They liked what they saw. They thought that I had a beautiful body, and that let them know that, you know, they could take a self-defense class. They weren't going to lose their husband or their boyfriend. They're going to retain their femininity.
Well, the mere fact, though, that you teach self-defense and you teach them at different places throughout Los Angeles, as you stated earlier, isn't Playboy or magazines like Playboy have been accused for years that they kind of get in the wrong hands of the wrong people who tend to do the kind of things that you're protecting women from being assaulted?
No, well, some women might think that it was a contradiction for me to do Playboy because it portrays women as a sex object. But my feeling is that for 10 years, I've been doing what other women talk about doing, and that's you know, leading my own life, you know, making my own decisions, being liberated. Although I don't say I'm a women's, you know, liberator. And I feel that my decision to make Playboy, to do Playboy, I made the decision.
Yeah, in other words, you're an independent soul.
Exactly. I made my decision to do Playboy. And a lot of women dream of doing it, but don't have the guts to do it.
Before we go, you brought some tape over of Helen Reddy. But before